Hello everyone, welcome to the course of Microwave Engineering. In today's class, we will be learning about microwave power measurement. So this is the concept. We will know about how to measure the microwave power or power of the wave which is running in a waveguide throughout the bench. This is for little bit introduction about low frequencies at microwave frequencies. Okay, if we want to measure low power, we can use directly voltage and current equation. Okay, from these impedance and power factor, phase angle can be calculated with the help of voltage and current measurements. Okay, when we go for measure microwave frequencies, it is more convenient to measure micro power instead of V and I. The properties of devices and the circuits can be used at micro frequencies, characterized by S parameters or S matrix, power, frequency and the voltage standing wave ratio and noise figure. So before that, let me see the definition of microwave power. What is meant by power? The power is defined as the quantity of energy dissipated or stored per unit time. So this is very important. This is for common definition. Okay. So microwave power is divided into three categories. One is low power measurement, which is less than 10 milliwatts. Second one is medium power measurement, which is starts from 10 milliwatts to 10 watts. The third one is high power measurement, which is greater than 10 watts. The average power is measured while propagation in the transmission medium is defined as P average equal to P peak into duty cycle. Duty cycle is nothing but the pulse width of the signal. Repetition frequency is most convenient unit of power at microwave in dBm. So all of you know that the unit of power is dBm. Okay. In generally, we have to know about that general measurement technique for average power is to attach a properly calibrated sensor to the transmission line at any port at which the unknown power is to be observed in the microwave test bench. So everyone know that in today's all the educational institutions are using microwave test bench setup. All the values can be measured with the help of VSWR or directly we can measure X band power meter. Okay, so with the application of T junctions like E plane T, H plane T, magic T or direction coupler, etc. Okay. In micro power meter consists of power sensor which converts the micro power into heat energy. How we can measure the heat energy? So we can measure the heat energy with the help of the temperature variation, which means the corresponding temperature is rise provides a changes in the electrical parameters, the output current in the low frequency circuitry. If we measure the microwave high power measurement, especially we can use for calorimetric method. So see that second point, the output from the sensor is connected to an appropriate power meter. So that's what I told, that if all the meter consists of power sensor, the sensor has to be converted the power into micro power into heat energy. Okay, then the RF power to the sensor then turned off when the power meter is reading is zero. This operation is often referred as the zero setting, that is called off condition. Okay, when we on the power meter, the sensor reacting to the new input level sends a signal to the power meter. The meter has to be indicated some values. That values can be observed. The reading has to be changed according to the temperature variation. Okay. The sensor has to be divided into two categories. First one is devices whose resistance changes with applied power, such as Schottky diode detectors or sensors, polarimeter sensor, thermocouple sensor, etc. These three are used only for low power measurements. Okay, when we go for high power measurement, we can use for calorimetric method. Okay. Okay, the first one of low frequency measurements. The low power measurement, Schottky diode detectors or sensors. See that diagram shows that this is for zero biased Schottky diode sensor. Okay, this is for zero biased Schottky diode sensor, which is used to square law detector whose output is proportional to the input power. So if we apply the input RF input signal to R1 resistor, the signal has to be passed through R2. So after that, the diode can be detect the input signal. So then converts into heat energy. The corresponding temperature rise provides a changes in electrical parameters, which outputs current in low frequency circuitry. So we know that it is the output power is proportional to the input power. Okay. It all about measured about the temperature variation. The next one is, this is also low power measurement technique. So polarimeter sensor, the polarimeter sensor is also power sensor whose resistance changes with the temperature as it observes microwave power. There are two common most type of polarimeters are, one is parameter, another one is thermistor. So parameter is sensor is short thin metallic wire sensor which has a positive temperature coefficient of resistance. Second one is thermistor sensor. So thermistor sensor also temperature sensor. The semiconductor sensor which has a negative temperature coefficient of resistance. This can be used to measure the temperature with the variation of electrical parameters. Okay, the impedance of these polarimeters are ranges from 100 ohms to 200 ohms. Okay, the compared to zero biased sensor, which that is Schottky diode sensor, it has less power measurement, which is 20 dBm. For thermocouple sensor, it has two dissimilar metals and a semiconductor sensor. This is also low power measurement sensor. It generates an EMF when two ends are heated up differently by absorption of microwave power. Okay. In this thermocouple sensor, has to be connected resistive load deposited on a SI substrate, which forms an one electrode of the thermocouple for cold and hot material. The output leads going to be DC voltmeter or RF ground circuit. The output meter reads pure DC voltage in the output side. For example, square wave detector, or we can say square wave modulated microwave signal. Okay. So that's all about low power measurement. Next one is high power measurement, which is called calorimetric method or calorimeter method. So calorimeter method sensor is high power microwave measurements can be conveniently done by the calorimetric method, which involves conversion of microwave energy into heat. See that first point. Then measuring the temperature with the help of rise of fluid in the water. So we can easily calculate the power with the help of calorimeter method. Okay, see that circuit diagram. Sorry, that block diagram. So first, see that process. So normal water enter in the pump, water inlet, then we can measure the inlet temperature. So after that, that water can passes through the microwave waveguide. So after that, we can measure the outlet temperature, then that water can be outleted from the flow meter. Okay, flow meter also we can note down the values. Okay, so how we can measure the, how we can measure these temperature variations when we apply the microwave power in the input waveguide. So that glass tube has to be raised the temperature, so the inlet temperature and the outlet temperature can be compared with the original value. So we can easily observe the, we can easily find out the difference of the inlet temperature and outlet temperature. So and finally we can observe the original temperature power. So how much power can be passed through the waveguide? There are two types of methods are used in the calorimetric method. One is the direct heating method and another is the indirect heating method. The rate of production of heat is measured by observing a rise in temperature of dissipating in the medium. Indirect heating method, in this method heat is transferred to another medium before measurement. In both methods, static calorimetric and the circulating calorimeter are used. See that value consists of 50 ohm coaxial cable, which is filled by dielectric load with a high hysteresis losses. See that value. Okay, this is for static calorimetric method. Next one is circulating calorimetric method. So in circulating calorimetric method, calorimetric we can use either fluid or water is constantly flowing through a water load. The heat introduced in the fluid makes exit temperature higher than the input temperature. The average power is given by P equal to 4.187 Vd and Cb. This is for calorimetric circulating method. We can easily measure the output power. Thank you for watching.